Hello everyone, and welcome back to another tutorial where we'll be creating a Dragon Ball Z style character. So this is the character that we'll be creating today. This was actually a special request from one of our subscribers. So thank you Andy for suggesting this idea, and let's get right into it. I have already looked at certain models that we can use for this tutorial, and I found this one to be more suitable that can work with Headshot on Character Creator. And special thanks to OneClix on Sketchfab, and I'll leave the link to this model in the description below. We have all the files that we need for this tutorial, and let's drag and drop the 3D model into the viewport of Character Creator. We can see that the model is low poly. Let's go to the Modify panel and increase the subdivisions over here. This looks better. We only require the head of this model. So let's go ahead and select this model, go to Edit Mesh and select the faces, and click and drag the rest of the body of this model and click on Delete Faces. So now we just have the head of this character, and we can go ahead and open Headshot 2 plugin. Click on Mesh tab over here and click on Start Head Generation. So a new window pops up where you can see there are two different 3D models. The left one is just a reference which we are going to use to create the align points on the right. So let's move the camera over here so we can start from the point 1, and then we'll assign these points on the Dragon Ball Z character on the right. So on this model, I can notice that the only complex thing is the eyes. So we just need to make sure we add additional points later on to properly align the points of the eyes. We can notice that there are only two extreme points for the human eyes, but for this cartoon character over here, it has four extreme points. So we need to add these points later. For now, we'll use the two extreme points of the human face as the diagonal extreme points for this character. And I'll increase the number of points over here to 35. So we can have additional points to assign. So now that we are done with the 35 points, we can add additional points over here. And we will also add some additional points for the nose, and two additional points for the nostrils, so there are no extrusions happening on the model. So we'll add some points on the ears. You can see that there's an extreme point on this model. And now that we are done with this, we can go ahead and delete these two points on the top of the head and at the back, because we don't have those details. We are going to use the effective area of just the frontal face and the ears included. We can see that the jawline of this character, it's not clear. So let's go back to the alignment points, and we will add two additional points over here to give the detailing of the jawline. So now we can go to the third step, which is Refine Mesh. We will use the Smooth option over here to smooth out some parts of this model. And the rest of the deformation, we can fix it to the CC character directly. And now we can go ahead and attach this head to the CC character. We will leave the settings at default, which will use the textures from this model onto the CC character, and leave the body type to male and select the masking of just the frontal face and the ears. So this is the CC character that has been created from the headshot, and we'll go ahead and make some changes to make this model much better in the part 2 of this tutorial. Thanks for watching.